I mean, it's one of those. Well, I mean,
Dire
if
team.
he has Aghanims, it would disable crits and aura, so.
That's something at least.
Or wait, no,
Yeah.
it wouldn't disable aura, it would disable crit though, because it's
No.
passive.
Regardless, I think at this point, I think it's a good choice. And this provides them. It's not as gritty of a draft as the last one was. They don't have an Elder Titan. They don't have a Keeper of the Light. They're not stacking jungle camps. They're not taking with Illuminate.
Ten
They're not, you
seconds
know.
remaining.
They can get kills in light with Visage and Wraith King. It's almost the complete opposite.
Five
And
seconds
Secret are like,
remaining.
let's not do that again. Let's not pick that lineup again because I really like. I'm pretty sure
Observe
Kroki's like,
time.
can you just like, I want farm. Like, as somebody that has played core, not necessarily in a professional or competitive role, but like as someone that plays core often and you can't get CS because your lane is
10
just,
seconds
it's not
remaining.
going well, I feel like it could be a bit frustrating. So I can imagine Kroki. Oh, wow. Wow.
Empires.
I don't think anybody expected that.
That's a
All
troll
right.
pick.
That is a troll pick.
I think Syrah's actually quite good, and I think it's a little underused. He definitely functions in a lot of. I just find it a bit strange, though, that they pick a troll with no real other right-click hero in their lineup. I mean, usually a lot of times when we see this troll pick, we'll see it
10
comboed with the
seconds
Void
remaining.
offlane.
Right.
So then you aren't necessarily forced to go this Mask of Madness
5
because you
seconds
have the Battle
remaining,
Trance.
sir.
And, it's just a bit surprising to me that they pick up the troll with no real other right-click hero. But we'll see how this goes.
The Silent Lancer coming out for Empire as well. An interesting decision. I guess that's a way to stop
I
Wraith King
mean,
Troll from jumping on your
they're
face.
gonna have extremely good teamfight and kiting power. I think it's gonna be very important how much work they can get done inside the Ravage and the Coil. Because after that point, it's gonna be really difficult to chase into these heroes now that they have this Venomancer and the Elder Titan, which provides a lot of control.
It's like a reverse of the last game almost, where Secret were the ones that had plenty of kiting potential, and then the Puck and another AoE control hero were on the other side. But Team Secret have the Puck now. They also have the Tidehunter, and
10
they're
seconds
still deciding
remaining.
on who's going to be picking up what hero here. But this is definitely not the draft I was
5
expecting for
seconds
either squad,
remaining.
especially Silent playing the Venomancer and the troll pickup for. But I'm down for it. I don't think I'm going to complain about this. I'm completely fine. So we will jump into the game here. Second game between Empire and
Prepare
Secret.
for
Empire
battle.
looking to keep pace with some of the top tier teams in Group B. Unfortunately, they lose game number one to a really solid Team Secret team. And Secret, they're looking for their fourth victory here in Dota Pit League Season 2 to go along with what has already been a very good couple of months for their existence. Again, going back to Starladder, a second place finish there. And the Summit EU qualified to the Summit household where they'll be going to Southern California, where I will also see them there. I will see some of you guys hopefully on stream as I'll
I'm
be at
jelly.
BTS. Yes, I've yet to announce, but I'll be at BTS to help out with
Well, I guess you
observing and
just
casting as well.
announced
So,
it.
listen, I had to get it out there at some point in time, but again, very excited for that. But we're at Dota Pit right now. We're going to focus on this game. So, for your Secret squad, they're already putting some five-man aggression here into the enemy jungle. Kuroki is going to
30
lead the way
seconds
on your
to
Troll
battle.
Warlord, Puppey on your Wraith King, Big Daddy No Tail. He'll be playing your Visage, S4 playing your Puck, and to round it all out, leading the backside is going to be Simba on your Tidehunter, playing your offlane, more than likely.
Yep, and Secret do go into the jungle. Go ahead and block up the two big camps for the side of Empire. Not wanting them to stack any of these camps or do any jungling on the Doom in the early game, so.
The battle begins.
We'll see. It looks like Secret might. They're going to pick up the Haestrion, then Puppey and Big Daddy No Tail are going to head back up to the top lane. Make sure Kuroki gets free farm in this top lane. They can also roam kind of effectively. Visage is maybe not the best roaming hero because of those nerfs and also lack of disables, besides his obviously Grave Chill. But Puppey can certainly roam around, especially with the Haestrion. He can also head to the jungle at some point, maybe when he gets Vampiric Aura, gets Treads or something along those lines. We'll see how this goes, but. It's gonna be Yoki in the jungle
Yoki
now.
not gonna be too happy when he looks into this jungle
It's
and
like,
doesn't see
can I
any
get
creeps.
sentries, somebody,
Oh, he is
please?
gonna get an Alpha Wolf, so probably the actual best creep to start with at level 1 if you're gonna go look towards that laning.
The problem is he has no other jungle camps to work with the exception
Yeah.
of Mud Golems over here, which I guess is fine. Mud Golems are not bad for Doom to work with, and then like the small camp, which is currently getting pulled, and Solo's probably gonna chain pull this as well. So, I mean, Yoki's gonna get nothing unless he goes to the enemy jungle,
Yeah.
which I don't know if that's a possibility at this
point. I mean, he is at level 2, so...
Yeah.
Not too bad, and they are getting the offlane experience onto this Elder Titan. Aren't really able to shut him down currently.
Alright, well, I guess it could be worse then, but already Kuroki having a much better start than he did previously with 6 last hits. His base damage at 65. High base damage for an Agi hero without any real stats, so he's got Ring of Protection, Stout Shield, Iron Branch, and some regen going through as well. Bottom lane, Simba is... I don't know if they can... They need to Gale him to kill him, and I don't know if they can, even with Gale, especially at level 1. Poison Sting at level 1 is not going to do much. I mean, Telekinesis and Fade Bolt. There's not really any burst damage, assuming he gets his Anchor Smash off.
It looks like they actually missed the connect, so Simba's actually going to get quite a lot of experience in this offlane. Yeah, there's two ranged.
It is pushing out rather quickly, and I'm not sure what happened with the Mud Golems there, but somehow it doesn't work out.
And Addy's always getting harassed
down. Yeah, he's going to work, man.
Getting that staple a lot of gun, pop though. Shots.
That staple gun, though. Thing looks so stupid. What is this thing?
It's the stapler.
Alright, well, whatever. It's just a giant stapler that he's holding in his hands. On the backside, Simba getting Venomous Galed. Silva's gonna come in. He's got Telekinesis. They might be able to get this kill. Simba's low. Telekinesis back. Fade Bolt could go here. He's gonna try to TP out. Fade Bolt, is it enough? Oh, so close, but good try. Simba Silent gets the kill. Alright. He almost survived. That would have been amazing.
Yep. It's a really important kill on the side of Empire to get the kill onto Simba, but it looks like... Oh, does he not have money for a TP swap? Why isn't he TPing bottom? There's a lot of experience to be gained. An entire wave of experience, so he's pretty much... Did he try to... Is his
TP
on cooldown?
Maybe he tried to TP and canceled it? Okay. I don't know, I didn't see. I'm not 100%
sure. Maybe his TP must be on cooldown, because otherwise it doesn't
really make
sense. Oh no,
he was trying to TP out, remember? He was trying to TP out when he was here and he was dying, and he died, and he got killed.
Well, I didn't see it, so that's why I was asking.
Yeah, he was trying to TP out against Silent and the Rubik, but he canceled his TP in the process. I got confused for a second.
I was looking top, that's...
Always want to fly. He's getting wrapped on. Grave Chill's gonna go. Wraithfire Blast from Puppy's available. Do they have enough damage for this kill? They have level 2 Whirling Blades, and the Stomp's gonna come in. Nope, just kidding. Big Daddy gets the kill with a right click. He actually gets a Gravekeeper's Cloak first. No Soul Assumption just yet, but the Whirling Axes does more than enough.
An interesting choice to get the Gravekeeper's Cloak. I suppose it will help him in trading hits with the Elder Titan. Maybe not thinking that he needs the early point in Soul Assumption to get any kills, so... A bit of an awkward build coming out from No Tail, I'd say.
Maybe it's
not something we see every time.
I mean, he has zero armor without Gravekeeper's Cloak, I think.
Yeah. Well, and it does help him trade, so.
Yeah. I mean, like, that's also another change to Visage. He literally has no armor unless you get Gravekeeper's Cloak, so. We'll have to see if he continues to level. I mean, I imagine he'll get Soul Assumption. Meanwhile, Telekinesis actually solo picks up a double damage rune, and Simba needs to be careful. He'll take a bit of right click, and Simba is actually kind of having a rough time. They did not ward his ancient stack, though, but they will have a ward to spot out if he is heading over there. So this ancient stack is going to be pretty important if he stacks it up. He's currently actually heading to the jungle. We see this a lot for Tides on both sides of the map. If you're having a tough time, head to the jungle and take some creep camps with your Anchor Smash, and he should be able to do just that. But that means that this bottom lane is free farm with 22 last hits for Silent. But Kuroki, this is what we were expecting in the first game from him. 27 last hits, and he's only going to get better as the game progresses, I imagine.
Yep, and looks like Silent opts for the early Arcane Boots. Not something we always see in the safe lane. I think generally the safe lane build is those treads, but it looks like he's going to go with the Arcane Boots. Probably most likely going to make a mechanism first item.
Yes. And then maybe a Blink Dagger to get, or an Aghanim Scepter for his ultimate to just poison everywhere. God.
Wow, S4 is actually winning the mid lane against Scandal in this Puck vs TA matchup. Typically considered a counter pick to Puck, and doing really well for himself, sitting at 26-8.
Rune Coil is gonna go. There is no Waiting Rift. S4 doesn't throw it. There's the Wraithfire Blast. He does have Melt Strike, but there's a Sentry on the ground. There's the Waiting Rift and the Illusory Orb, and S4 just jaunts forward and says, hey, you're dead. This is why he is a $1 million Puck, I suppose. Yep. And Big Daddy gets the kill top and always want to fly as Kuroki and Big Daddy were diving a bit into the tower. Wow,
well,
two heroes.
Pretty unbelievable play from S4. Winning a counter matchup pretty heavily, up by 10 CS, so... Secret definitely doing a much better job in the laning phase this game if we compare it to the previous game.
Yeah. And they won the game without really winning a single lane last game. What can they do when winning almost, I'd say, well, two lanes. Definitely not bottom lane. They're not winning bottom. Silent is doing a nice job of pushing in. And he has level 3 Plague Wards, level 2 Poison Stings, so he wants this tower, and Sibba can't even really walk forward without taking a couple of hits of poison. Telekinesis is going to come in. There's the Venomous Gale as well. A Plague Ward to block Simba's path. TP comes through. Anchor Smash helping out a bit. And Big Daddy's going to TP in just to make sure Simba survives. The tower might not be so lucky, though.
Yeah, this tower is going to take a lot of damage from these Plague Wards, but it should be okay, at least for the moment. They look to continue to pressure.
Well, top lane, Kuroki's sitting.
They are going to Gale No Tail on the bottom lane.
Telekinesis? This time he's in some trouble as well. TP coming in. Fade Bolt was already used. No Tail should fall to the Poison Sting. He's very low, and it looks like he will take a spill. He does go down, but Silent actually gets destroyed by S4. Here comes Puppy as well. Solo's going to fall, and S4 getting a double kill. This guy's up to 1,400 gold already. He's had a really good start in the mid lane and
really
bottom lane
rotation.
As well. Rookie top lane, manning up onto Always Want to Fly, throws up the Whirling Axes, both melee and ranged. Bash, bash, bash. He already used Battle Trance. This has been quite the fight. There's a TP coming in. I think Kuroki might die here. Astral is not available, but Always Want to Fly can try to catch up. There's going to be the Battle Trance. He gets one kill before he dies to Solo.
Wow.
Big mistake by Solo not lifting him.
And on top of that, Puppy actually denies the bottom tier 1 tower.
Kuroki really should have gone down there without getting a kill onto Elder Titan. A bit of a mistake by Solo, so...
I thought when he turned there, he was going to die, and without getting anything. I mean, I always want to fly. That was just a bit unfortunate. Doom, Yoki, we haven't seen much out of him. He's got his Midas now at 7 minutes and 50 seconds, so despite his jungle being warded, he seems to be okay. He'll be able to catch up with this. He doesn't have boots yet. He'll be able to buy them now. He's got Devour if he wants to use it as well, so that's off cooldown. Bottom lane, Puppy and S4. Is Silent dead again? I think they don't have Dreamquill for 8 seconds. They can just wait, and Silent will probably just die here.
Yeah.
Puppy's gonna run out. They're gonna look for Wraith Fire Blast. There's the poison over. They won't get it off. Illusion Orb, Waiting Rift. They don't need the Dreamquill. Silent's gonna fall. Puppy doesn't
Puppy's
have his level 6. He's actually
here.
Dead, and S4 might be dead as well. He does have a wand. Puppy's about to fall.
Him?
No deny. Yeah, he just runs away, actually.
Oh,
they didn't want to die.
So he actually couldn't be denied.
No. Regardless. S4 does survive, so 1-for-1 exchange, but a support for a core, more than decent. Solo does pick up a double damage rune and stole Anchor Smash. Ravage is available for Tidehunter if he wants to use it at any point in time, but...
Yeah, not too yet. Bad for Empire, though. Whenever you're getting ganked and you're able to get a return kill on a 2v1, always going to be good for you. No. And it does look like, yep, he's going to be going for that Mana Boots into Mechanism build. Pretty standard. Usually we see this build on the mid lane, and... We saw it a couple times at TI4 when RFK was playing the Venomancer a lot.
Mm-hmm. So it's been a while. I've seen it here and there, but it has been a month or two, I think, since I've seen this build. I haven't really seen a Venomancer altogether in a while. Also, I feel like the support Venom has just kind of come and gone. S4, Waiting Rift is going to go, but he's taking a lot of right-click damage. He'll be able to jaunt away, and that's the problem. Scandal has done so much damage to S4, but he can't really secure a kill. They have no way of locking him down with just Scandal alone. And S4 will have his Blink Dagger by the time he gets back home, so...
And, I mean, you just see how much work Tia can do against Puck in this matchup, and Scandal finally now pulling ahead as he was losing the matchup in the early stages. Looks like they are going to pressure this mid lane as Silent does cut the creeps... So the creep wave is going to fall, and they should pick up this tower fairly easily.
Buckler's popped, and yeah, this tower's going to go down. Refraction charge is going. There is a rotation coming through from Kuroki. Glyph is going to go as well. Dreamcoil onto 2 from S4. Jaunt, Waiting Rift, Silent in some trouble here. Wraithfire blasted, Whirling Blades destroying that poor, poor Venomancer. Ravage goes. Now there's no refraction charges. Goodbye, Scandal. He's dead for 30 seconds, and they deny the tower. That's 2 towers denied. S4 is playing out of his mind. Top lane, Telekinesis, Big Daddy. This will be their return kill. Maybe. Gravechill coming in. And he is trying to sprint his way out of there, but Yoki just throws up the, I guess, the mana burn, getting the kill there. Interesting choice for Yoki, but whatever.
Alright, I think that's the first time I've ever seen mana burn get a kill.
And, I mean, whatever works, I guess. Solo does steal familiars, by the way. That's actually probably the most annoying thing in the world. Glyph gonna come out. I don't think they're gonna deny the tower. Ooh. Oh, good try. Solo has these. That's just gross to think about, but... Well. S4 going bottom again. Scandal. And S4 going toe-to-toe, this time in the bottom lane. Phase shift blinks away. He disjoints both projectiles. Nicely done there. But I don't think he wants to really try to stand toe-to-toe with S4 anymore at this point. Brokey is your CS leader with Vlad's and Treads at 70 CS and 15 denies with 5,000 in net worth. Yoki's pretty close behind. A lot of that is because of the Midas and his Devour. He's got Tranquils as well. But, I mean, at this point, you know, it really comes down to just secret transitioning into the mid to late game. I mean, you already have your Blink Dagger on S4. Maybe they wait for Tidehunter to get maybe his Blink, but he's very far away from that. So I don't know, maybe try to go for a Roche at some point because you have Medallion and Vlad's up on your Troll. You're going to have Vampiric Aura as well from your Wraith King, so yeah, that's kind of interesting.
And I mean, we have seen the power of the Elder Titan in the late game, so Empire definitely have a strong late game composition with the Doom and Elder Titan. Doom, definitely not a hero to scoff at in the late game, and he is farming quite well. He's up to Midas, Tranquil Boots, has a kill himself. And doing really well, actually, on this jungle Doom. Second in net worth.
Crow gets stunned. Fade Bolt goes through. Haste is still up there for Silent. There's going to be the Astral coming in. Crow is low. Stomp misses. That actually hits onto a couple, but there's the Poison Nova. They blow up poor Rubick. Big Daddy trying to TP away. He should make it out just fine. Puppy is rather low. He still doesn't have his reincarnation yet. He actually has 9 stick charges, and he might have to get denied here. He's rather low as the Poison Sting is taking him down.
He doesn't have a skill point either, so if this hits him, you'd actually have died.
Yeah. That was kind of a sketchy situation to be in.
Well, not even saving a skill point for Reincarnate. That's...
He's getting the most out of his skills, at least, but...
Yeah, I mean, he hasn't been in a situation where he would have died without Reincarnate, so...
So they actually pick up a kill on Rubick. Kuroki was getting God on, but he's completely fine. He'll continue to lifesteal in the jungle. I like how Empire are playing right now. They're playing aggressively. They want to just cut off the map again of Secret, but what can they really get done? Yoki does have Doom. He hasn't used it yet. I think he's trying to get towards a Blink Dagger before they really start fighting. Mm-hmm. Once he gets a Blink, he could Doom some heroes. Maybe they start going to work, but...
Yeah, fairly close to that Blink Dagger. After he uses this next Midas... He will have that blink up, unless he decides to go for the Aghanim's Rush, but I think it's pretty... I'm pretty sure he's going to go for that Blink Dagger.
He's, I think, heading to the side chef now to purchase it up, and...
Yeah, it's just such a good item. And Tide is actually struggling.
Oh, S4 gets the kill! He TP'd right after the Dream Coil, too! Waiting Rift, S4 has... God, he just knows how to play this hero. I mean, there's nothing else to say other than that S4 is a goddamn puck player. Like, yep. He knows what to do on this hero, but he's gonna get doomed. Yeah,
he's gonna die here.
S4 is in some trouble, getting chased down. He might be able to deny himself to the Dark Soul Summoners. No, I don't think so. Yoki gets the kill, but the trade that's happening is that Roshan is getting taken down and that the Kuroki should get an Aegis here. Mm-hmm. And he also has a Hyperstone, by the way. That's quite nice.
So are we going to see a Mjolnir or an AC coming out of Kuroki?
Oh, that's the question, isn't it? Uh-oh, solo. Buddy, you are not in the right place. Wraithfire Blast was stolen, but that does
looks like
not
he's
much.
Trying to do a bit of warding, but ends
Soul
up getting caught.
Comes in. Wraithfire Blast, he's dead, but they get a return kill. Actually, they killed a Simba who was doing the Aegis attack, and actually Scandal came through with a double damage rune, and I didn't catch that kill. Kuroki's on the high ground. Kuroki wants to jump on Scandal, and he might be able to kill him, slowing him down with the Whirling Axes, but decides against going further. And okay, 1-for-1 exchange.
So, I mean, Yoki is doing a really good job on this Doom, much better than Simba is doing on the Tidehunter, really struggling in this game, up to 1800 gold. They did get the Roshan, and he killed the majority of the Ancient stack, but ends up falling again, and just delaying that blink again and again on the side of Empire. So,
although he is close, Simba's gonna have it within creep camp or two.
An 18-minute blink on a Tidehunter, not really something that you want to be having happen.
Well, luckily, S4 has been making a lot of space for his team.
S4 has been playing fantastically this game.
It's actually ridiculous how many kills he's got. It's 4-1-3.
Scandal does have an Invis rune, scouting out the players from Secret.
There's no sentries around that I can see. So actually, he's not going to get scattered. They do have the sentry here if he decides to dive pretty far, but he's not going to go... way out of position, and so they'll just sit back and continue to farm. Yeah, S4 has 7 kill involvements, And they have 12 kills in their team. So 7 of the 12 coming out from S4. Scandal picks up a Batarune. Familiars are coming in. He's going to Melt Strike one and destroy it. The other one is pretty close to dead as well. So pretty good that you could just destroy those almost immediately with Melt Strike. So.
Yep, he can at least kill one of them.
And he has Phase Drum, by the way. Scandal picks up Phase Drum. And this is where I like Templar's Ask because there's a lot of choices you have. Phase Boots is really good early game with Drum as well. You can even pick a Blink Dagger if you really want to. But I see Treads a lot as well. How do you feel about the Phase Drum this game for Scandal on his Templar Assassin?
The Phase Boot choice?
Yes.
I mean, I think you either go Phase Boots. I don't really... There's not much difference, honestly, between Phase Boots and Treads. I mean, Phase Boots give you a bit of extra mobility, and then Treads give you the option to Tread Switch and get more refractions, but...
Oh, S4 waiting Rift Dioki right as he was about to do him. But there it is. It's going to go off regardless. Kuroki does get a kill on Silent. They will trade a core for a core. Meanwhile, Wraithfire Blast going to go in. Solo getting chased down still. Great stomp as well. The Telekinesis flying. Sibba not going to get Earth Splittered. Scandal is doing work though. Sibba about to fall. He did pick up his Blink Dagger. He did not get to Ravage. Kuroki's coming in. He does have the Aegis. I don't know if this is their fight though. No Tails coming in. If they can take down Scandal, they can win this engagement. And they're about to. They will take him down. Buffy has Reincarnation. He's about to use it. Kuroki, Aegis is there, but it's not being used yet. And if he falls, he'll have to wait a couple of seconds to get back involved. He does have no whirling axes now. He's out of mana. He's lifestealing it up with the ranged axes. Will not get the kill there. They've actually lost 4 heroes. Well, 3, I suppose. Aegis and, of course, the reincarnation have been expended. Yoki getting pushed back, but Silent does TP in. Poppy and Kuroki backing away now as they see the rest of the squad is running after them. Telekinesis, that'll be a Poppy. Venomous Gale coming in. And the Whirling Axe is not going to do much there. The level death getting the kill, and they get yet another one for Empire. Kuroki is still here. He wants to man fight, but he's alone.
They do have Ravage and Blink.
Oh, maybe he's not alone. Simba's here. Stomp's going to go. Ah, he actually canceled it. They can still go if they want to. Silent's up, but they won't. They back away. Secret say, we don't want to take this fight. There's no real reason to.
Yeah.
Kind of an awkward engagement, and that actually helped Empire a lot, I think.
Yeah, Empire definitely coming out ahead in that fight. They blew the reincarnation, the Aegis went down, and it looked like Secret were going to be able to maybe turn that around and come out with the advantage. They were able to kill Scandal there, but...
Oof,
that was really close.
That's the second time that familiar he's stun. Either died or almost died to a Dream Quill, but he's TP'd out. And he's made himself away, so...
And it doesn't look like he's going to be going for that Yule Scepter build as he gets the Ring of Regen with the Staff of Wizardry, so...
Four Staff
looks
time.
Looks like he's going to go for a Four Staff. I don't know. I really like... I think Yule's is just so good on that hero.
Yeah, I think...
I mean, it helps the Four Staff is a bit more supportive in the sense that you can Four Staff your allies and you can't Yule's your allies, but... I think Yule's gives a good combination of self-defensive ability as well as it's a really great offensive tool.
Brookie's been sitting on this Hyperstone for a while. I'm surprised he hasn't finished up whatever he's working on. I guess he has really kind of lacked...
I suppose it's going to be the AC, right? Because if you're making a Mjolnir, you would just buy the Maelstrom first.
Yeah, there would be no reason to buy the Hyperstone. Yeah. Well, in hindsight, yeah, makes sense. So the Assault Cross will be his choice. Armor Reduction... I mean, his right clicks against towers and even heroes, it's actually just going to kill people until they can get an Assault Cross of their own.
Yeah, and the armor is quite... You want the plus armor against Elder Titan, so it makes a lot of sense.
Yeah, that's a smart decision. And it's the second game in a row that he'll be going for the Assault Cross. The first game, I don't know if it won him the game, but it certainly helped in them taking like three sets
of
rats right in a row.
Yeah, well, they had already had an MKB, so it made sense the first game. And... Yeah, you definitely want to have a Vlad Zand and AC when you're playing against the Zelda.
TP coming out. Familiar stuns are going to go. Always want to fly in Silent. They're going to get brought down here. Gush coming in. They do get off the Poison Nova, but one dead, two dead. And, well, that's unfortunate. But they do get the kill top. Solo coming through with Yoki. They pop to Doom. They get the kill on Kuroki, who is farming freely in that top lane until they came and killed him.
Yeah, Yoki is absolutely enormous on this Doom. Already up to is the Aghanim's. 20-minute Ags, Blink, Midas on a Jungle Doom. It's a really impressive farm.
Yeah, and I mean, Empire actually have the net worth lead by about 3,000. Experience-wise, they are losing about 2,000. But at the same time, this doesn't feel like the first game where Kuroki's playing like an anti-mage or something. I mean, Troll's good, but I mean, Yoki could probably just deal with him later on in the game. And especially if he gets a Refresh Orb. Not only can he deal with Kuroki, but he can deal with like S4 or even Simba. So it's going to be maybe a bit more difficult this game.
This game, the Elder Titan on the side of Empire, so Secret aren't going to have that natural order in their back pocket for the late game. Instead, it's going to be on the side of Empire.
Yeah, another Elder Titan that becomes the crux of a lineup here for the most part. BKB or I'm pretty sure that's a BKB and not an SNY on Scandal, but I've been wrong before.
It should be a BKB.
Yeah. Well, he's going to get jumped down regardless. That was a gang squad if I've ever seen one. He pops the refraction and dies immediately. They just jump out and say, "How are you?" And they kill him immediately. Surprise! He's dead. 44 seconds. He does have buyback, but they're not going to use it, obviously. This tier 1 tower is going to go down. The Assault Cuirass is going to take, or at least put some extra pressure on it. S4 takes the tower kill. Meanwhile, top lane, Silent is going to split push. He is going for Ags. He shouldn't be anywhere near it. In fact, his mech was done. And he has really farmed this point booster.
It looks like they might just give the second tower away as well. No way. Doesn't look like there's any effort to slow or stop this push down.
Stomp up
they are sending the spirits, but
puppy now.
Looks like Empire are pretty content with split pushing. They're gonna have Silent and Yoki pushing up this top lane.
They've spotted always wanna fly. Great chill. They are diving. Earth Splitter's gonna get off, but what is that exactly doing? They actually are, I think, gonna give this tower away now. And they might be able to TP and defend. They're pushing the tier 2 tower top
They're pushing the tier 2 tower mid.
As well. I don't know, they're going to have to make some TP's happen, and they're going to have to make them happen soon. They're going to TP and probably towards the mid lane.
I'm not sure they can get either of these towers, but they're going to put a lot of pressure and do a lot of damage to them.
The mid tower
already
as well.
Up to 500.
Who's going top for Secret? Anybody?
Looks like they might end up getting this top tower. That's actually quite good for Empire.
There was no way they were going to contest bottom, and I feel like Secret could have contested top if they wanted to. Yeah, I don't know if that was a freebie, but
it's very difficult because if you TP in, who do you TP in first to top? Because they're actually instantly gonna die. And if you TP the Tide first, he's gonna get doomed and not be able to ravage. Yeah. If you TP in Kuroki first, he's gonna get doomed. I think it was actually just a bit too hard to defend that.
Yeah. Maybe they could have TP'd into the tier 3.
Tier 3, yeah.
I don't know if that would have done anything. They would have to. I mean, we could argue about it until Cows come home, but honestly, at this point, it's a free tower regardless for Empire, and they're still looking good. I mean, at this point, you have to wonder if Yoki either purchases up. We used to see an Assault Cuirass in this situation, but he already has the Axe Scepter, and there's no real reason not to go for a refresher here, other than maybe getting that Assault Cuirass, which someone else might be able to buy later on in the game. Meanwhile, there should be a fight. Kuroki and Scandal are looking at each other. Bash from Roshan. There's the Melt Strike coming in, the Whirling Axes coming through. He's gonna throw the Whirling Axes as well, the ranged version. Meanwhile, mid lane, there's a fight happening. Stomp's coming in. Wraith fire into Silent. He's getting low. The right click. Ravage, it looks like, was already used. Silent gets brought down. Yoki, no doom yet. Sibba, well, he's gonna actually just go down. The level of death doing work there. Three dead, though, on the side of Empire. Meanwhile, on the back end, they're still fighting. Scandal looking for the puck. Puppy backing away from the Tidehunter, or rather the Doom. Scandal comes in. Meld Strike. Scandal, you've overstayed your welcome. Wraith fire blast is gonna go. Now there's going to be the Grave Chill as well. Can they chase after this? They decide against it. A fight that's all over the damn map, and we actually might not
have
even done
like
yet.
Looks like Empire might re-engage.
Yeah, Doom, Invis Rune, Aghanim Scepter Doom, by the way. He also has a Mithril Hammer. Is it Big Daddy? Is it S4? Oh, he could just kill S4 with a level 4. Dead. Yeah, he just hits him once again. He just gets out of there.
They know they're Roshan too. This could actually be a really big play for Empire.
They will take the Roshan. Yoki not going to go in. They will zoom up Big Daddy now. No Tail getting chased down. There's going to be the Whirling Axes coming through. Tail gets to send a Puppy. Wraith Fire Blast still goes back into the fray. Kuroki and Puppy, they both have respawns. Kuroki's already getting low. Yoki has already used his Doom. There's the Aegis coming in. They can't kill solo. Puppy's still alive. Now he isn't. The reincarnation is going to go. Meanwhile, Tidehunter is alive, but no Ravage. Kuroki's getting chased down. Do they have any way to get him out of the pit? There is a Forest Staff. Kuroki's like, please, please, he can't get there. He cannot get to the high ground. Puppy getting telekinesis as well. He does get the kill at the very least, but he's dead as well. Four dead. Empire turning it around. And that also gives Yoki his BKB. They waste the Aegis. They waste the reincarnation. They're going to go for this 2-2 tower. What a huge fight for Team Empire.
Yeah, pretty much the only thing going right for Secret there was killing the Roshan.
Stomp's going to go. And now
really
this
well
is...
played by Empire. I think it was a mistake for Secret to continue doing Roshan. I think once Yoki revealed himself to S4 with the level death, they should have actually just immediately evacuated.
He was too close to the pit. I'm not sure if they could have.
Yeah, I mean, it would have been close, and I mean, that's pretty much the difference this patch when you're taking Roshan. It's not as safe anymore.
No. I mean, and also the bash on Kuro. I think that was earlier on in the fight, but that certainly didn't help. But, I mean, they did take down Roche quickly, but it didn't matter in the end.
And a BKB now completed for Yoki, so...
Yeah. I don't know if
How
he's
do they
killable.
Deal with Doom?
I don't know if you can. At this point, you have Alpha Wolf aura on top of the Doom, plus a Blink Dagger, a Midas, an Aghanim's, and a BKB. He can not only right-click, but, I mean, Doom and Level Death are really effective as well.
And Doom,
they do have an Aghanim's, though, for
S4. It does over 1,200 damage at level 16. An incredible amount of pure damage, so... It almost kills off. If he dooms anyone and he stands next to them for even, I would say, 3 or 4 seconds, they're just gonna die to the doom.
Yeah, I mean, everyone has about a health pool of at the most 1500, which is, by the way, Puppy. He's got the most health on the squad. But. And on top of that, we're not even. Well. It's frustrating to deal with at the very best for Secret, so. This has been really rough for them. They couldn't find the team fights earlier on. I mean, despite S4 carrying the early game, they have yet to transition into anything that resembles a late game, or at least looks good in terms of right click, because Kuroki just dies too fast on this Troll Warlord, I feel like. And that's an issue. I think that's one of the reasons why this hero's not picked that often. He's not necessarily paper thin, but...
But what carry wouldn't have died like this against this Elder, Titan, and Doom?
True.
It's actually just a really difficult combination to play against. I think actually maybe having the Wraith King as a core would have been better this game. Just because it is a natural AC carrier, and having the two lives against the type of lineup that Empire have could have been quite effective. Well, but then you would also have to deal with getting kited by the Venomancer, so... I mean, it's a really hard decision to make.
Yeah. I mean, Puppy is trying to build into some items here, but... I mean, he's still pretty far away. He's trying to build towards the Blade Mill. And that's not... I mean, he does have a blink, to be fair, but that's not going to provide much. Meanwhile, Battle Trance going in. Silent getting caught out. Scandal's here as well. They have to back away. The three familiar stuns do more than enough damage to help out, and Big Daddy gets the kill. No-Tail getting chased down with the Astral. Telekinesis, the stomp is going to go as well. No-Tail is sleeping for a while. And there's going to be the Air Splitter. He is done. Always going to fly, gets the kill with his ultimate. So, one-for-one exchange. And... I think the reason why they didn't go for Yule Scepter is because they've gotten so many kills in the back end of Telekinesis plus Astral Sleep. Oh, they know Solo's here. Goodbye. You're dead, friend.
Kind of unfortunate for
Solo. He's just one of the most unlucky people I've ever met. He just gets caught out of position every single time, it feels like, in some of these games. It's like, even if his team is doing well, oh, I'm dead. Oh well. But at this point, I feel,
yeah,
again...
it is going to be... So it was that BKB for Scandal. So he now has that on top of 3,200 gold.
Yeah.
Probably going to be looking towards a crit next, I would imagine. Most likely not going to be finishing up that Mantis style.
Oh my goodness, they get another kill. And... Puppy jumps on top of an Always Want to Fly, who gets caught in a position, and they secure yet another one. 25 to 18. So, back and forth we go. Although, they're getting these pickups, I still feel really comfortable for Empire right now. I mean, in terms of what position they're in.
Yeah, Empire definitely with a commanding lead. But I think... So how can Secret come back and win this game? So you could... Maybe they need... They definitely need a refresher on this Tidehunter, because that will be very important in these teamfights. So maybe a refresher Tidehunter, and then trying to get this Wraith King some right-click damage, I believe. Maybe with the Mjolnir or something. Might be their ticket back into this game, because they're going to need more damage sources than just this troll. So if they're able to get the refresher on the Tide, that'll give a lot of AoE magic damage and the disable.
Now, they have a long way before they can get to some of those items, though. Like, refresher on Tidehunter is... He does have 2,400 gold, but still.
Yeah.
I mean, that's an expensive item. And all the meanwhile, Yoki just continues to farm. And he has 4,000 gold. You have to imagine what he's going to go for next. He's actually going to BKB in.
Knows, probably.
Wraithfire Blasted going to solo. Puppy was ready to fight. Illusory Orb going through. Will not jaunt further. Yoki's ready to blink further and maybe try to doom somebody. Astral's going to go in. Puppy's going to take some harass from that. The Poison Ward's going as well, but... Stomp misses onto Puppy just barely. He actually was able to get out.
I suppose it could also be a refresher on the Yoki, but... I think it's more than likely going to just be a Shiva's.
I'll wait and see. Place your bets now if you're playing at home, folks.
The Aghanim's was completed on S4, and we've talked about this a couple times. It's good and bad, I think. I think a Hex is definitely better, but maybe feeling that, you know, he might not have the time to farm a Hex before he needs an item that gives him more impact in these fights. And it does actually provide a really good control zone for Troll so that he can auto-attack them. And they do have some trouble about getting kited in these fights, so
yeah.
The Coil is going to lock them down, as the Aghanim's Coil does pierce through BKBs, so...
I think that was a major issue after the, like, during the first engagement of that Roche fight, when they were outside of Roche and they were kind of chasing up to the high ground over here and down over here. There were just certain situations where they were getting kited around and there was nothing they could do about it. Kuroki does finish up his BKB, by the way. So, at least he's got that going for him.
Yeah, but if he gets doomed, what does that really do?
Nothing. But, at the same time... Maybe you hope to God that they doom the Puck or Tidehunter after.
I mean, maybe you do what... Was it EG? Where they just masked Lincoln Spheres in the late game?
I don't remember. I don't know if I saw that game. I probably should have, but...
You were casting with me. Or
was
no,
I?
It was... Never mind, it was Skurk.
Alright. I was like, are you sure? Oh, was it the 72-minute game? Or
yeah.
However long it was? Okay.
Yeah, EG
the
masked
EG game.
Yeah, they masked Lincoln Spheres. And it actually made it quite difficult to figure out who you should doom, because...
Oh yeah, I do remember that. I watched the end of that game. Mm-hmm. It was kind of ridiculous. It is the Shiva's card, by the way, that you were talking about for the for Yoki. I'm still holding on to the hope that he'll get a refresher eventually, but who knows if that'll
happen. It wasn't Doom, it was something else, but...
Regardless. Puppy... It wasn't Storm. I feel like it was something like that, though. Puppy getting stomped now in the mid lane. Will they jump on this? Here comes Yoki. Oh, Shiva's is going to go. BKB's going to go. Kuroki gets doomed up. He's the target. Earth Splitter. Puppy. He's going to take the majority of the damage. His ultimate's about to go. Kuroki's about to fall as well. They do pick up the Visage. Puppy is solo. The Poison Sing. And Kuroki's dead as well. He does have buyback. Already four down. Sibba and... Puppy, the only ones alive. Puppy getting right-clicked as well. He'll take a spill. Double kill for Always Wanna Fly. Staples away onto Team Secret. What a fight. Empire coming out on top. And Simba has to TP away. They're even going to get the familiars coming out. Silent, rather. It's going to be actually the jaunts up. Solo looking for it. I couldn't get the one familiar. Now they're going to go to the high ground. Buyback is available, but I don't know. At this point, Empire looking to just take the Tier 3 tower and back away. They don't have Doom. Solo is not there yet. Scandal is taking the brunt of the tower damage. They're going to back away. S4 was smoked up Simba as well. They still have Ravage, and that's why Empire aren't pushing in. They don't want to have to deal with the Ravage,
yeah.
I think.
I would sort of say this is sort of the beginning of the end, because it's just so hard for Secret to find a way to come back into this game. I think they're a bit out late gamed with their compositions. You know, they have the Troll, not really the best late game hero, and we've seen what Doom does to this hero. I mean, he just dooms him and then... They ignore him, because he doesn't actually output that much damage, especially with the item build that he's chosen. And he sort of was forced to go this item build because of Elder Titan's natural order, so...
Goodbye, Solo.
A very difficult game for Secret to play against in the late game.
Yeah, luckily they haven't had any success for Empire pushing up to the high ground, but... That only takes one more team wipe, and all of a sudden Secret are... In a really bad position.
Yeah. Well, they didn't use Ravage in that fight, so...
Yeah.
I think that the double Ravage could be a way for them to get back into this game, but still quite a long way off from that point.
And they're always the ones getting initiated on, too, in this game, it feels like.
They really need... I think once they get that refresher, or they should even maybe try to go for a smoke gank, they really need to find a fight where they can initiate onto Empire.
Now, they've gotten a couple of kills that way, but no actual fight, because Empire are generally split-pushing. They're away from each other on the map. They're not really grouped up as one, unless they have a specific objective in mind, which is killing everybody on the side of Secret. Scandal picks up an MKB, by the way. He also has a double damage rune, and he'll head back home for some mana, it looks like. Meanwhile, top lane, Silent has done a nice job of split-pushing. Not the quickest Aghanim Scepter for a safe lane farming Venomancer, as he doesn't even have it yet. He did pick up a Veil in the meantime. He's getting close to it. Roshan is about to respawn, and Secret know this. They're going to head into the pit, and they're going to try to take it for a third time, which means cheese. And an Aegis as well to boot, obviously. Kuroki now, of course, still sitting at Vlad's. Assault Kuros BKB, but you asked the question in that last fight, or before it, rather. What does it matter if he gets doomed? Well, I mean,
Aegis is certainly... Aegis is certainly one way to deal with the doom. If Kuroki is able to get an Aegis, then... dooming him... Dear. Do they know that they're rushing?
They
the question.
Actually are just pushing down mid.
Well, they actually kill Roshan so fast.
Battle Trance, Assault Kuros and stuff. Yeah, that's just ridiculous. They might jump on them here. Silent Plague Ward's gonna catch up on the no, Silent Shiva's Guard's gonna go. They blink further. Kuroki, BKB's. Yoki's gonna try to fight this, but now he's just trying to run away from Kuroki. Doesn't even want to pop the Doom, obviously. Now they actually catch up Puppy or Punchy. Puppy catches out, always want to fly. There's gonna be the Telekinesis down. Astral goes. Waiting Rift hits as well. They're looking for a stomp. There's the Wraithfire. Silent in trouble. Gonna get jaunted on as well, but there's the Poison of a Veil goes through. But Puppy with the Blade Mail. Silent. Say your prayers. Big Dream Claw into three. S4 doing a nice job. They haven't killed anybody yet. Puppy Reincarnation is now down. Always want to fly. Gets blown up. Now they can fight. Scandal pops the BKB, but here comes Kuroki. He's just right clicking down with the Battle Trance. Puppy gets a double kill. Yoki blinks away. So does Solo. Three dead. All of a sudden, Secret are doing it yet again. Luckily, there still is buyback for Scandal. However, two dead on the side of Empire. They are looking for their mid-tier 1 tower that they have yet to take. Finally, the glyph is going to go. It'll be back up for the tier 2. This will make it tough to push into for Secret. Mm-hmm. But at the same time, they take the victory, and they're going to keep pushing.
Yeah, I would say that fight was about as good as it gets for Secret. Empire initiated onto an illusion of no tail, so they wasted quite a few spells, and their smoke and the surprise factor was also wasted. And... then after that, they sort of clumped up for a Dream Coil. The BKB was also wasted on the Doom, and they had the Aegis, so that fight pretty much going picture perfect for Team Secret, and I think it was a bit of a mistake for Empire to actually take that engagement.
Yeah, and they engaged onto an illusion as well. Yeah. And Silent just got caught out of position. They're trying to force the buyback here. Kuroki's going to get Wraithfire Blasted. They might be able to take him down without having to really do anything and make sure he expends that Aegis. He's actually just going to back away. They don't want to push too hard for this Tier 3 tower. Kuroki is so low. He will survive, though. He'll head to the jungle, regen up with either Vampiric Orb or just the Vlads. And
Simba getting really close to this Refresher Orb, and I've talked about it a couple times. I think that's pretty much their ticket into the late game, as far as coming back into this game and having a chance to win.
I mean, at this point, it's looking solid.
Puppy up to 3,000 gold, so I expect him to look towards a damage item, most likely that Maelstrom into Mjolnir.
Venomous Scale. Silent, actually, you wasted it, buddy. Wraithfire Blast is going to come through. There's going to be the Whirling Axes, and he's going to mech himself, but... no, that's just going to be...
He's just going to do his own horn.
He's dead for 55, and... he did have his Poison Nova, but he didn't use it. He was about to. He veiled up everybody on Secret, but...
so they still have the Aegis. The cheese is also available.
Reincarnation
so
should be up again.
This might be a big moment for Secret if they're able to push the high ground here and maybe get a Tier 3, even a Rex.
Yeah, Puppy still has Reincarn, and... 3,000 gold to the bank. Simba is getting close to the refresh like you talked about. Puppy jumps forward, always want to fly, getting caught out. Kuroki looking for the tower now. The stomp actually got stopped by Puppy jumping at the Rainfire Blast stolen by Solo. Here goes Kuroki. Ranged Axes whittling down the melee racks. They're going to back away. Whirling Axes going through. The Familiar is taking some damage here from Scandal. No engagement just yet. Kind of just tiptoeing around each other. Puppy throws the Wraithfire Blast. Solo disjoints it with a blink. Scandal thinking about jumping in. There's the reincarnation done. Now more damage out of the range racks. Battle Trance goes through. The glyph is going to get popped. And backup is going to be Venomous. The Venomancer, rather. And yeah, this is their call. Get out. Simba should, I think, have his refresher. Let's see. I don't want to be able to do math here. 1675 plus the recipe is how much? It's what, 1800? He's close, isn't...
for Simba?
Yeah, he should have it, I think, actually.
Yeah, he has it now.
Yeah, if he wants to buy it, might Simba buy back. Nope, there it is. Alright.
So, Secret slowly clawing their way back into this game. I would say again, off the back of these Aegises, just abusing the dire side advantage really well.
That smoke from Empire, had they smoked at a Roshan and taken them down where they were taking Rosh, they probably just... I think with the game at that point in time.
Yeah. Although they do kill it so fast, so.
Yeah. It's really
I don't even know if they would have gotten there in time, walked straight to it.
Yeah, it would have been close, to be sure. And I don't know if you want to take a fight in the Rosh Pit anyways against a Dream Coil and a Ravage, but regardless, That's all behind them. Now they've got to find a way to deal with the push coming from Secret, the double Ravage. There's the Axe Scepter dump for the Venomancer, so this is going to be a bit more annoying, but...
Maelstrom done for Puppy.
I think S4 is going for a refresher as well. He has the Oblivion Staff. I don't see him picking up an Orchid. I just don't see that happening.
And Mjolnir is actually going to be a really big pickup from Puppy, because all of Venomancer's DOT damage actually will proc the active from Mjolnir. Sorry. And it's a really good item this game.
Yeah. Still needs the Hyperstone and the recipe, I believe.
Yeah. He's quite a ways away from it, but...
I mean, at this point, I think if they win the next fight, they probably just win the game anyways. But S4's going to get caught out. Does he have buyback? Absolutely. He's going to get doomed, though, and he's dead. Level death. They won't need a buyback, I don't think. They're going to try to force it, maybe, for Empire, but...
It looks like he's actually going for his own refresher, so he's going to have a double Aghanim's Dream Coil at some point this game.
Yeah, that's a long duration.
That's actually pretty insane.
Like, what, 14 seconds of coil duration and then 8 seconds of stun, I believe?
I mean, it all depends on how the fight goes.
Right, well,
I mean,
obviously. But...
You can never... It's like, Dream Coil is actually such an odd ability.
It's a bit strange, to be sure. Blink Ravage is gonna go on to Scandal. Now the Gush. Ravage not stolen, it's Anchor Smash. Scandal getting away. Wraith Fire Blast, BKB'd. There's the Veil. Silent only pops in onto Kuroki and Puppy. Silent getting bashed up. There's one. Silent gets blown up by the Whirling Axes. Dream Coil only onto one. Always want to fly. Trying to get away. Puppy chasing him down. There's the Wraith Fire Blast going through. Can they get another kill off the back end of this? There's the Gush from Simba. He already refreshed. He has another Ravage to work with. Solo blinks away. He's got it another 8 seconds. He's got a Yule Scepter, so he's pretty speedy. And Scandal and Yoki are getting the hell out of Dodge. And now it looks like Secret are pushing down mid. Always want to fly has buyback. Silent does not. I think Puck bought back for that too.
That was a really risky push from Empire, because they used the Doom to kill the Puck, but not really knowing if Puck's buyback was down or not. They sort of were playing with fire, you know, if Puck's buyback is down, then we can probably take this Rex, and probably they could easily take a 4v5, but Puck was able to buy back. There's no Doom on Yoki, so his effectiveness is pretty much cut in half, but now he has that Refresher Orb, and that is just such a huge pickup for this Doom.
Puppy jumps in, Yule Scepter comes out, Scandal, destroying a lot of these birds, and obviously the Creep Wave as well. Lose your Orb flying through once again, and Empire now, they will defend, and back and forth we go. This game is... It feels like it's nowhere near completion, but I don't know. Who knows? Scandal jumps forward. Telekinesis. BKB for Kuroki. Scandal pops his own, but he's getting bashed. He gets blown up. He does have buyback, and he might have to use it. Yoki is looking for a Doom target. He's going to find Big Daddy. Refreshes up. Shiva's guard as well. Kuroki, he wants to Doom him as well. Puppy, he's got his reincarnation. Doom's up simple. Kuroki's going to fall regardless. It's like... he's gonna get right clicked down, godlike for Yoki. Double kill coming up from him as well, as the Doom did go through. Puppy reincarnation is back up. Telekinesis, Empire's gonna right click him down. S4, what are you doing there? He's got no buyback. He jumped in and died. 4 dead for Secret. It was looking so good, and all of a sudden, well, they do have buyback on every single hero with the exception of S4. Still tough though.
It's at that point now where they actually just have to kill the Doom, because if he gets off this double Shiva, double Doom, it's just... These fights aren't winnable anymore, because he's going to remove two heroes completely from these teamfights.
They're going to try to push down mid, force out these buybacks, or... Who knows? And luckily, they will respawn at about 30 seconds, with the exception of the Puck, 60 seconds. They're going to have to hold this without.
So, what is the buyback? Four. Okay. So, Puppy buys back. They...
Roll Invisage Habit.
Yeah,
always want to fly, gets forced out. There's the Ravage coming again. Yoki doesn't have his Doom for another 30 seconds. Always want to fly is low. Kuroki comes back in. Whirling Axe is going to go. It's going to hit on Yoki. Can they get this kill? He's got Blink in one. They will stop it, but the BKB's up immediately afterwards. He's going to run away. There's the Anchor Smash going in. They really want to stop this Blink, but they can't get close for the Anchor Smash to hit. They do not cancel the Blink Dagger, and he's able to blink away. So they only get Always Want to Fly, and that's all they get out of it. And now they will have Refresher. They won't have a second Ravage for a minute, or rather 2 minutes, I should say. Empire Silent TP's away.
Yeah, he's not going to use that Refresher, because Refresher was still on cooldown when he popped the Ravage, and you don't want to... It's not an effective use to use it at this point, because then his Refresher is going to be on cooldown for... It's basically 80 seconds longer of not having double ult, so...
This is...
Yep, and Empire just keeps overextending when they don't have Doom. Like, we saw that, that's the second time they've actually walked up the hill without Doom. And every time they've done it, they've paid the price for it. That time they only lost one hero, but the previous time they lost, they ended up losing three, so...
At the same time, they forced out buybacks on everybody from Secret,
yeah,
I think.
Yeah, they did.
Except for Tide, I mean, which he didn't die in that last engagement. Actually, Visage didn't buy back either.
No, two buybacks. But so. Probably worth the two buybacks in that situation, but yeah. Still, it's a little greedy to be walking up the hill with no Doom.
Rosh is up, and Empire, they've maybe realized their mistake. They know that they're around this general area. If they go into Rosh and they try to take it, they're going to spot out this psionic trap. There's no reason for them to fight. Link recoil, Ravage goes in. Can they focus Yoki down? Maybe a jaunt. They will lose Scandal immediately. Ravage looks like it was stolen coming out, but it doesn't matter. What can they get done? Doom onto S4. Double Doom might be coming soon. Yoki getting bashed up, but there's the Earth Splitter. Wraithfire Blast Puppy bringing him down low. Yoki is going to fall potentially here. 500 HP. No, he's still alive. He's able to blink away, and Secret have actually lost three heroes, and I don't think Empire have lost anybody unless they bought back Kuroki. Right click down, double kill for Yoki. Secret lose four, and they might as well just lose the game right now. Silent getting low to these Visage birds, but they cannot secure the kill, and they're gonna counter ward. They're gonna take Roshan. In fact, the only hero alive is Puppy. He's gonna try to defend the bottom tier 2 tower. He has to blink away immediately. And by the way, yeah. Is there any buyback up besides it's only Simba at this point?
And who do they give the Aegis to? So they're gonna give it to Scandal. So Scandal not really going to be a good target for Secret in the next fight, as he's gonna have two lives. And I mean, they just can't deal with Doom anymore. He's gotten to that point where, I mean, the late game Doom is just so strong. Probably one of the best heroes in the late game. You know, he might not dish out that crazy right-click damage, but Doom and Refresher, just an incredible combination.
They actually just couldn't deal with it. It looks like this is just get the kill and always want to fly. He overextends for whatever reason, and they deny the tower.
He's trying to get the last hit on the tower.
Silent is way too close to the base. No-Tail's looking for a grape shell. He might find it too. No, no such luck. Now, luckily, Secret haven't lost their racks yet, but...
Yeah.
I mean, they're getting close.
I mean, they still have opportunities to win this game. They still have the double Ravage. If they can find pickoffs on this Doom, that would be tremendous. But he does have so much armor and a 3,000 life pool, so... I think Secret are just, at this point, lacking damage. Puppy does pick up his Mjolnir, but... Is that really going to be enough damage? I mean... The troll having about 200 right-click damage, no crit to speak of. And Wraith King actually at about 200 right-click damage himself, and he does have that nice 3x crit multiplier, so... I think for Secret to win this game, they need one more damage item onto Puppy, and he's actually just going to become the carry this game.
I mean, this is the problem I had with Kuroki in the beginning of the game, or where I thought the fault may lie, is that... Right-clicking as a troll warlord later on down the road, I don't know how much that gives you. He's a very good early game hero, and especially for taking Rosh, but and even towers to a certain extent. And you talked about it in the draft, they just didn't have any of the right-click heroes like a Faceless Void maybe inside of a Chronosphere. Mm-hmm. But now they've got to try to defend their base without any buybacks. Your Scandal is Aegis. I don't know if they commit to this if you're Empire, but maybe you have to. I don't know if you really want
to
wait any
you
longer.
Have to, if you're on the side of Secret, you have to hope that Scandal overcommits and loses his Aegis without you blowing any ults. Because I think if you use anything onto Scandal's Aegis, the likelihood of winning the subsequent teamfight is just quite low.
I mean, Scandal is the one that does get blown up so quickly. He's gonna get jumped on. Puppy will throw up the wave Wraithfire Blast as well. Gets crit up. Now the Ravage is gonna go. There's the Poison Nova as well. Puppy caught in it. And Puppy is about to fall, but he does have Reincarnation. Yoki dooms up now onto Kuroki. Kuroki running away. There's the Shiva's Guard as well. Double Doom going in. They're taken out of the fight. Aegis does go. Puppy is right-clicking. Always want to fly down. Puppy is manning up. There's the Cheese. Scandal right-clicks him down. Everyone is low. They will get a couple more kills. S4 jumps in. Jaunts away. Yoki is godlike still. Beyond godlike even. They take down Simba. Kuroki stays alive, but the set of racks is now done. There is no buyback for Simba. He could not get his Ravage off. He couldn't even get double Ravage off. Kuroki is now not doomed up. He's got to try to defend the best that he possibly can without the help of Puppy. He's got his Blink Dagger now. No double Doom anymore. And no Aegis as well.
I completely forgot that Solo still had Ravage.
Yeah, that he actually popped it up. S4 jumps in, waiting rift. Here we go. Yoki's back into the fray. No-tail pops the Shiva's guard. Kuroki gets slowed up as well. There's going to be the Soul Exception, and the axes are stolen. Kuroki's going to try to man fight. Great Yule Scepter from Solo. Scandal man fighting. He wins the man fight. There is no buyback for Kuroki. Yoki chasing down Big Daddy No-tail. And the Earth Charge and the right click should do the job. Double kill for Yoki. Yoki has not died this game. 16-0 and 13, and it looks like it'll remain that way. His Empire take a second set of racks, and more than likely the GG in this game as Secret. They only have a lone puck. Simba is respawning in 8 seconds with double Ravage, but by that time they might have lost their third set of racks. And S4 is looking for something. Meanwhile, walking down mid, it is going to be the Elder Titan as he's making his way downtown, walking fast. They're looking for this Ranger Rax top lane. They're doing some damage to it already, Solo. They're going to jaunt up with S4, Waning Rift going in. There's the Gush from Simba. Force forward, Ravage goes through. He's going to refresh it. He's looking for a double, but he actually has no mana left. He's going to pop his Arcanes. Doesn't go for the second. And now they are still fighting. Puffy jumps in, always want to fly. Dream Coil onto two. Doom onto S4. He just gets it back up again, and S4 cannot buy back. Puffy now getting right click down. Solo, he is actually the one going to fall here. There's the Reincarnation back up. Gems on the deck, not that it really matters. Venomous Gale completely wishes me silent. And there's going to be another Ravage. Always want to fly. He's dealt the damage, but Yoki jumps back at level depths onto the Simba Tidehunter. Puppy now. He's got that Blade Mail. It's not doing anything. Buyback from S4, but at this point, that's all, folks. Secret lose their top lane of Raxor about to. Waning Rifts. S4 is actually trying his damn best to do what he can. Big Daddy's back into the frame, but there's the Rex gone. Stomp is up, No-tail getting right clicked down by Yoki. The bird's chasing after Silent, the Soul Exception as well. Shiva's guard, he finally gets the kill. Yoki still has yet to die this game. He might die here. Pops the BKB, he wants Big Daddy. He's got level death, he doesn't even need it. Now he's getting chased down by Yoki. Shiva's guard goes yet again. Punk is still alive somehow. But again, I've said it. It's Mega Creeps, and Secrets still have yet to kill the Doom at 52 minutes in. Silent jumps in, Veil's gonna go, as well as the Poison Nova. Kuroki immediately pops the BKB. Silent kinda just suicided himself. He pops the Knight, he's not dead yet. Kuroki's actually dead! He just died. S4 now getting chased around as well, or rather is chasing around, gets level death. That's another kill, this time for Silent. GG finally called, five heroes dead, and Dotapit, for the first time, Secret have lost. And they're going to be 3-1. Empire move up to 5-3 with Yoki playing one of the best Doom games I've ever seen.
Yeah, and honestly, Yoki played phenomenally well in both games. I mean, he played a really fantastic puck in the previous game, and I mean, what a Doom performance this game. I don't think I've ever seen an 18-0 Doom.